Atul, and might be Arvind is someone else, someone sitting in the room, that's fine. Just like to quickly introduce myself. I am from an organization called Piramal Swasthya, which was known as HMRI previously. It was known as HMRI 104, and we've been working in Assam and the rest of the country for the last 4.5 years. I'll talk about, you know, very quickly, in about 5 to 8 minutes time flat, in terms of who we are and what do we do. Just something about us in terms of who we are. We are actually an NGO, a non-profit organization, part of the Piramal Group. We leverage technology, which is ICT, in the field of health. We've got two models of working. One is a PPP, which is a public-private partnership along with the state governments, and a CSR model, where we are right now working with the private organization and helping them implementing their CSR projects. We have some key services which once again leverages technology. We've got a 104 health information helpline across the country. We've got a mother and child tracking system. We have telemedicine services, and we've got mobile health services across the country. We have presence almost in most states of the country, and right now we have presence in Assam and Northeast in terms of having a presence in Arunachal Pradesh. Right now we'll talk about two case studies. One is Sarthi 104, which is the health information helpline. I don't know how many of you must have used this service already in Assam. All you have to do is just dial 104 from your mobile, and you get connected to an associate with whom you can talk regarding your medical issues and health problems. The other one that we'll talk about is the mother and child tracking system that we have in Assam. First, about the Sarthi 104 health information helpline, which is a helpline formed for the people of Assam, the beneficiaries, and you can call up to get health advice. You can call up for counseling, which is to do with your mental health, depression, domestic problems. This is the first of its kind in the country. What you have to do is, all you have to do is just have a mobile, and all you have to do is just dial 104 and you get connected to our helpline. You can get directory information, as in, let's say if you are in Jorhat and you want a blood bank in the middle of the night, you can call up 104 and get the information. So everything is available at your fingertips using your mobile phone. So what we do is, there is no rocket science in terms of what we do. We have used the penetration and we've used the reach of the mobile phone. All you have to do is just dial up and get the information, get the advice, and be benefited from a very simple call center model that we have. The advice is given using very, very validated algorithms, but from the end user perspective, it's a very simple process. All he has to do is just dial 104 and you get connected to the helpline. We also log complaints for improving standards of the government. So 104 is used as a phone number where you can call up and complain about medicines not available, doctors not available, you know, hospital equipment is broken, and we log it in our system and we have it passed on to NRHM for investigation. So what we do is, we have a clinical decision support system on the basis of which we give advice. So as I told you, at our end it's slightly complex, but at the user's end it's very simple. All they have to do is dial 104, and using our clinical decision support system, we give them the advice. So we have various kind of services that we offer using the 104 helpline, right from the you know, the RSBY, which is the Rashtriya Swasthya Bima Yojana, to the adolescent reproductive and sexual health, to ASHAs who call up, you know, using this helpline as their support mechanism once they help the you know, the pregnant woman under them. We use this helpline productively, and our USP is our scale of operation. Very few projects that we have which can be immediately scaled to the entire state. Right now the total population of Assam is around 3.1 crore, and this facility is available to the entire population in one go by setting up a call center, and anyone out of the 3.1 crore population, anyone having a mobile, can call up and avail these facilities. It's available 24/7, 365 days a year. It's a very easy number to remember. 104 is a free phone number. It's a toll-free number, and you can use this number to call up and talk to us. We have projects all over the country: Assam, Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, and other states of the country. We have a CDSS tool, which I've spoken about, which is a clinical assessment and decision support system, which is used at the back end to provide consistent advice. So you speak to associate one or associate two or associate three, there is the same consistent level of advice that you get from a beneficiary perspective. There is no difference. Unlike, you know, you go to a doctor, one doctor will advise you, you know, kind of diagnosis A, the other one will diagnose, you know, option B. But we at the 104 call center, we have an advice which is consistent, which is the right medical advice. We also use disease summaries, which is like, you know, validated by our domain team. So what we do is that we have our domain expertise, we have our IT expertise, and we have combined the domain and the IT expertise into providing a scalable solution which can be used all over the country by just dialing 104. I'll just skip these slides. Call flow, this is slightly more complex in nature in terms of how do we go about giving the advice. We have something called an e-prescription. What happens is if you speak to a doctor, what happens is if you go to a doctor gives you a prescription in hand. So here we do not give prescriptions in hand in terms of a paper format. What we do is that we send you something like an e-prescription, which is an electronic prescription. All you have to do is just dial up 104, you talk to the doctor sends you an e-prescription, which is like an SMS that comes onto your mobile phone. You go to a pharmacist, show the e-prescription and get your medicine done. So the consultation is done on the phone. So in terms of a person sitting on the hills of NC Hills or in Karbi Angalong, the tribal area, all they have to do is have a mobile phone, talk to a doctor and get the prescription and somehow go to a pharmacist, show the e-prescription and get the medication done. So in a way, we are able to offer it, okay, to everyone. Okay, so it's accessible, affordable and available, this kind of a solution to the entire population of the country in one go. This is the kind of prescription that comes into your mobile, which is like an electronic prescription. You need not go to a doctor physically. All you have to do is dial 104 and you get the prescription on your mobile. In case you are in a position to go to a pharmacist, get the medication. Otherwise, what we do is we also give you home remedy medicines. So for example, you know, we kind of tell you what to do at home using what we have at home. So it's like a situation where we have given you both the options. One is home remedy, one is prescriptions, you can use either or. These are some of the systems that we have in terms of how we do it. The doctor gives you the prescription and it comes onto your mobile. In terms of scale of operations, in the last 4 years, I'm very glad to share that we've received more than 78 lakh calls so far by the beneficiaries here. And we've been able to kind of, serve to the best of their satisfaction, almost 30 lakh calls. We've got more than 54,000 counseling sessions done. A counseling session is a session where you can call up and talk about your problem and the counselor, who's a psychologist, can actually talk about the problem in detail. This is the first of its kind in the field of mental health where people are very allergic talking about their psychological issues, and here you can call up 104 and talk about your personal problems, also your domestic problems, so on and so forth. We have given about 23,000 information. We have logged about more than 7,500 complaints. And we have got more than 29,000 calls from our ASHA workers across the field. This is about scale. The next project is about MCTS. This is a Government of India program inauguration by the Union Health Minister, the Union Health Minister Ghulam Nabi Azad. Very quickly in terms of what we do for this project, it's about pregnancy management in terms of ensuring the reduction of MMR and IMR. So what we do is that we monitor and manage pregnant women and child and ensure complete service delivery and ensure no dropouts. So this is once again an initiative which is in synergy with the Millennium Goals in terms of reducing the IMR and MMR of the country. We help with the ANCs and the PNCs. We motivate them for institutional delivery. All is done just using a simple phone call to the beneficiary's mobile. Once again, simple for the beneficiary. No rocket science involved. We give them a call and we have them talk to a physical person, not a machine. Like in the morning, Mr. Osama was talking about IVR and SMSs and videos. Here we have a physical person calling, a human-to-human contact, face-to-face contact in terms of the person calling up and helping them with the entire pregnancy management. So the services that we deliver using the MCTS call center is we get the database from NRHM. We've got members of NRHM here and they are the one who give us the database. We use the power of the database by giving calls from our call center to the pregnant woman, and we provide them these services right from the ANC, PNC delivery services. We kind of motivate them for institutional delivery. We inform them about government health schemes. We track immunization status and we provide a lot of services, whatever a simple phone call can provide. So once again, as I told you and I repeat, it's a simple phone call on the beneficiary's mobile and we give them all the possible advice that a person can give using phone call. We have a database of the pregnant woman and we have an application software and we kind of give them calls using the application software. We have two level of calls that takes place. One is from the paramedic. We have got ANM and GNMs who are trained to give calls to the pregnant woman, and we give them advice on the basis of their questions in terms of their pregnancy status, you know, whether they have iron deficiency, whether they are GDM, gestational diabetes, or any kind of problem. In case of any complication, the call is transferred to a doctor, which is you know, kind of an obs and gynae specialist, and he gives them a call, and he advises them further in terms of the pregnancy status. In case of a real problem, we actually refer them to the nearest public health institution and call up the public health institution and tell them, hey, you've got this patient in your area, please take care of it. This is in the quest to reduce the mortality, because the deaths take place of the complicated cases, and if we are able to address the complications first, then of course it will go a long way in terms of reducing the mortality. We get four calls for antenatal care. We have a scripts, and we've got these process outlined as per NRHM guidelines. We give them four calls postnatal, okay, post delivery, focusing on immunization, etc., etc. And we have bring about. We are yet to study the social impact. So the topic of this conversation or this workshop is use of mobile in terms of behavior and social change. So we are yet to measure it, but I'm sure with the kind of figures that we are able to reduce, we'll be able to kind of quantify this difference very soon. We've got some other ICT-based interventions that I would just very quickly like to talk about. We are right now using Android mobile application instead of laptops now for all the work that we do, because of the obvious benefits in terms of reduced cost, lightweight, handy, enhanced battery life, and so on and so forth. For example, in Andhra Pradesh, which is our head office in Hyderabad, we are doing a highway emergency accident management, all done using mobile application. We have sample reports that we get on our mobile phone. So, for example, right now I've got reports of all the projects that we are running using the mobile. We are upgrading ourselves from a laptop-based application to an Android-based application, which uses the power of the Android applications to provide services. We have these kind of Android-based mobile platforms where we capture all the data and upload them into the server. And right, for telemedicine services, we are kind of gradually going into the Android-based applications. We have a very good solution called the Doxin Box, where all the information is captured at the beneficiary end and transferred to the doctor sitting in Guwahati. So right now we are actually using this in 26 telemedicine centers across the state. We have got partners in success. We've got government partnerships all across the country. We are running the National AIDS Helpline along with NACO, which is the 1097 number. If you call up, you can reach our call center. We've got international agencies like the World Diabetes Foundation, MacArthur Foundation, and some private partners like Aditya Birla Group and Mahanadi Coalfields, and all of them we are working with. Some international and national partners further as far as who we are working with. A couple of awards we've got, the latest being that we've got the 2015 Times of India Social Impact Awards in the field of health, and proud to say that we've got this for the good work we've done in Assam. Thank you so much.